Hi there, my name is Laura. Welcome to this video where I will demonstrate some different variations of dancer's pose, Natarajasana. Natarajasana. So this is a standing asymmetrical balancing posture and it fits well into the theme of the heart chakra, Anahata Chakra, as it is a heart opening posture. It's a wonderful stretch for much of the front of the body. So let's go ahead and dive in. There's a couple of things to note as you're beginning, that if balance is something that is a challenge for you, as it is for many of us, then you might like to have a chair nearby. So you can have your hand to a chair, that can be a big support. Maybe just in your space that you're practicing and there might be like a couch nearby or a wall. So you can always turn to face a wall for this pose and, or even be beside it. So whatever works for you, depending on where you are in space, if you need that added support for your balance. I'm standing on a yoga mat. If you find that standing on a yoga mat with the squishy sort of support beneath your feet makes it more challenging for your balance, you might prefer to step off of your mat onto the floor, a more firm surface. I also have a strap here today. So there is the option at a certain time in this posture to reach back for the foot. So if you feel that that's unavailable to reach for the foot, but you'd like to give it a try, it feels available for your balance, then you might have a strap handy too. And I'm just gonna hold on to it. And we'll step toward the back of the mat or toward the back of your space, facing a little bit of room in front of you to move. You can begin in a tall standing posture. Maybe you come into mountain pose, Tadasana. Begin to notice the felt sense of both feet rooting down on the ground. You might even wish to shift the feet from side to side or the weight from side to side in the feet. And allow your weight to slowly come to center. A feeling of weight being shared equally between both feet. With the eyes softly gazing forward, can you find a focal point? Something that's not moving, a drishti. And this can be an anchor for you to help you balance. So it's important that your focal point, your drishti, is not moving and you can gaze there. Let's start to pedal out through the feet. So you lift one heel, then the other. Good, weight shifts into left foot. And with the right foot, just like you're walking, step forward. Weight draws into just the right side foot now. You're nice and tall. And you're light on the back left toes. So as we lighten up on the back left toes, we begin to challenge our balance. Brighten through back left leg. Shoulders draw down and back. Breath is steady, a micro bend through the right knee as you root through your foot. Your right arm reaches up toward the sky. While the left arm can bend at your side with the palm facing upward. So as you continue to draw your shoulders down and back, you might start to sense the heart expansion here, an opening. Maybe you sense an arch through the spinal column. And then if it feels right for you, as you're welcoming some challenge for your balance, you could begin to tap the left toes behind you. Just tapping left toes. Noticing how balance feels on the standing right side leg. Gaze at your drishti. Wonderful. Now, as you get a feel for your balance, this might be where you stay. This is dancer's pose already. We're here. If you wish to challenge balance even more, you may try lifting through the left toes, holding them up away from the ground. So we keep the little bend in right knee, a bit of activation through the core here as you open through the front body, low back nice and smooth. You may try stretching back for the inside edge of your left foot with your hand. If that's not available, but you do wish to give it a try, this is where our handy straps can come in. You might make a loop with your strap and you can tuck your foot into the loop, holding the strap instead. So you can begin to feel in either of these expressions, whether you're holding the foot in some way or just simply reaching your toes back, foot pointed, you can feel a lengthening through your left hip flexor, hip flexors and quads there in the front of your thigh and hip. If you are holding your foot, another variation, so this is just an option, is to start to tip forward with your upper body as your thigh reaches away from the ground. Happy that I have a wall here to help with balancing. Know that you can come out of the pose anytime that you need to. This is very, very strengthening for our standing leg while we stretch the front of the lifted leg. Even with the toes down, as you brighten through the leg, you still receive that beautiful stretch. Take another deep breath in here. Exhale, slowly release. Notice if you can take the whole length of your exhale to release. And you might pedal out through your feet or walk it out before we find Natarajasana, dancer's pose on the opposite side. So the body is often asymmetrical. If you feel that you may like to use a strap for the right foot, you can pick it up. You might not have used it on the opposite side, or you might just know your body and that the asymmetry may mean that this little strap friend will be helpful to you. So you could have it available. Lift one heel, lift the other. Gazing at your drishti. Right heel lifts, lowers. Step forward with your left foot, just like you're walking, drawing weight into the left foot and leg now. Right toes brightly reach back. So you're nice and long through the front of your right leg. Left arm lifting. Right arm can bend at your side. Remember, you may face a wall. I'll just quickly demonstrate what that might look like. Left hand in this posture could touch a wall. And then you can be bowing forward in that kind of way. Maybe onto a chair. Good. You might tap your right side toes, challenging your balance just a little bit at a time, or perhaps even lifting the toes, reaching them back, foot pointed. You might loop a strap around your foot or hold the inside edge of your foot. So we take the inside edge so that there's a nice expansion across the right side of the chest. On this side here, another variation is to begin bowing forward as you're lifting right knee and thigh up and back, maintaining engagement in the core, a soft bend to left side knee. And you might imagine while you're here that not only are you kicking your foot, your right foot into your hand, but you're also pulling on your foot with your hand. So there's those equal and opposite forces, like you're kicking and pulling at the same time. You might sense that that supports you, an energetic assist in lifting your thigh and your knee away from the ground. Take one more deep breath. Slowly releasing with just as much control as you can manage. Good. Now you can walk it out again a little bit from side to side. You might draw some circles or figure eights with your hips. Even going around the other way. Let's take a little pause in mountain pose. In Tadasana, weight shared evenly from one foot to the other. The arms at your sides. Steady, even breaths. Noticing the effect of balancing, challenging the balance. Though we might feel unsteady when challenging our balance, the result or the after effect is often a felt sense of density, steadiness, and in a more subtle way, focus, concentration, stillness. You can notice any sensation. And take a deep breath in through the nose. A full breath out of your mouth. Fluttering open through the eyes. Wonderful. Well, I hope that you had fun with Natarajasana, dancer's pose. Balancing postures so they can be challenging. It is a nice time to play as long as you feel safe and comfortable. So having those supports with you so that you can play and feel curious about them, feeling safe to explore some of those, some of the postures that are more challenging for our balance. Lots of benefits when we can explore the variation of the posture that works for our own unique bodies. Please do let me know how you liked the variations of dancer's pose. Maybe you can share your favorite variation or what you loved about this posture in this video. And I do have on my channel some other heart chakra practices that you might enjoy. You can find them in my videos as well. So I look forward to seeing you in some of that other content on my channel. Thank you so much. Namaste.